every one of us is facing this reality that he knows that I'm not clever enough, I'm not the biggest Talmid Chacham of the generation, I haven't learned enough, I don't know everything, I'm not... All of those doubts, all of those questions that we have on ourselves are making us weak and sad and confused and depressed. And then we're losing our self-esteem and our faith in ourselves, and then we don't know what to do. And we start questioning even those things that we know that we are right at. Because we failed once, and then the Yetzer Hara is trying to tell you, look at you, you're a failure. And then you start falling into that self-blaming, blaming yourself over and over, and breaking your own spirit, and falling for another sadness, and another depression, and another frustration. And again, you go with your sadness. So I found myself also struggle and confronting those situations many times in my life, and I realized that the Yetzer Hara is tricking me. He's just using my goodwill to destroy myself. And then came to me that thought, that verse that Rabbi Nachman of Breslev said once, that positive thoughts are thoughts of truth, and negative thoughts are evil thoughts of the evil inclination. So I realized that every time that I'm angry, or sad, or upset, or despair, or whatever, it's the advice of the Yetzer Hara, and I'm wrong thinking that way, and I need to change my way of thinking. And every time that I have faith, and that I have confidence, and that I'm happy, and that I have hope, and that I want to do good, those are thoughts that Hashem Yitbarach is giving me, and I need to go with them. And now I don't have no problem. Because every time I'm angry, I know I'm wrong, so I'm not being angry anymore. At least I know on what to work to reduce the anger, to reduce the sadness, and to come back to myself, to relax myself. And every time that I'm happy, I'm not going to let no foreign negative thoughts to disturb my happiness and my joy.
Just a temporary world, that in this world, in this period of time, we have a mission. What's the mission? The mission is only not to forget the Creator, to remember that it's all His, never to fall in the trap of all of those coverings, of all of those husks.